Good morning, everyone. A very warm welcome to Holy Trinity Church at Home. It is lovely to be together this morning. You will notice that I am in my home and not in church. That's because we are having phase two of the online technology put into church, the cameras, this week, so we can't use church. But the good news is hopefully we'll be able to have a live service from church next Sunday. This week our theme is love, and in the letter 1 John it says this: God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Let's say together our opening prayer. Lord God, we set this time apart for you. By the presence of your Spirit, fill our worship, hear our prayers, speak to us and change us. Form us into the likeness of Jesus Christ, so that our lives may glorify you. Amen. We're now going to sing that wonderful hymn, In Christ Alone My Hope Is Found.
Today is love. I asked a number of people what or who they loved, and these are some of the pictures I was sent. Pictures of pets, people, places and activities. But today, as once again, we explore this theme of love. What does it mean to love and what does love look like? I've got a little video for us to watch, which uses the famous passage often used at weddings from 1 Corinthians 13. Let's take a look.
Love is patient.
Like not honking the horn when you're already 11 minutes late.
Love is kind.
It's doing all the chores so she can wake up to a clean house.
It does not envy.
Being truly joyful when your friend gets the promotion, even if you didn't.
It does not boast.
Love does not remind your kid of his 20-game losing streak.
It is not proud.
How about we apologize more often?
It is not rude.
And let's not value a like over someone's feelings.
It is not selfish.
Love shares that last cookie.
It is not easily angered.
It breathes when it wants to scream.
It keeps no record of wrongs.
Love does not bring up the past, even though right now it'll be really convenient and totally win me this argument.
Good night.
Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth.
Love doesn't get excited when people get destroyed online.
It always protects.
Love always stands guard.
Always trusts.
Always leans into the promises.
Always hopes.
Always sees what's possible.
Always perseveres.
Always gets up one more time.
Love never fails.
And it's always worth it.
Some lovely examples there. Paul goes on in this passage to write the verse we are thinking about today, 1 Corinthians 13, verse 13, which Will is going to read to us.
And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
Thank you, Will. Before we think a little bit more about this verse, Cassa is going to lead us in a time of reflection and confession.
So we come to our sorry prayers, and this is a time for us to think about the ways where we haven't lived in love, we haven't loved God, we haven't loved our neighbours as ourselves. And we can say sorry for those times, and God forgives us. And that means that we can take away that burden on our hearts and be filled with God's love and grace. God of love, we confess we are sometimes impatient and often unkind. We are quick to envy and find subtle ways to boast. There are times we are rude and lift ourselves up as we put others down. Loving God, teach us to love. God of love, we confess that we are quickly angered. We are quick to record how often we've been wronged. There are times we celebrate the misfortune of others. Loving God, teach us to love. God of love, we confess that we put ourselves first. We're reluctant to give. We are slow to sacrifice. There are times we hesitate to protect. Loving God, teach us to love. When we're tempted to judge, to assume the worst, may love remind us to trust. When we're tempted to despair, to assume all is lost, may love remind us to hope. When we are tempted to give up, to assume it will never happen, may love remind us to persevere. Loving God, teach us to love. Amen.
We're now going to join together and sing the song, Give Thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever.
Oh, is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise.
So, a week from today is Valentine's Day. There are lots of different things that we might associate with this day. Love, hearts, flowers, chocolate, romance, maybe Cupid, often a familiar symbol of Valentine's Day. There's a funny quote that says, "I don't know why Cupid was chosen to represent Valentine's Day. When I think about romance, the last thing on my mind is a short, stubby toddler coming at me with a weapon." As I was thinking and reading and planning for today, this idea of a bow and arrow got me thinking, and that's what I want to share with you today. I wonder how many of you have had a go at archery. Well, when I've been away with the Year Sixes on their residential, one of the activities that we've enjoyed is archery. After being given very clear instructions on how to use them, the staff and children in turn are given bows and arrows. Now, bows and arrows are great, but actually what else you need is a target. It would be silly having archery without a target. It would be like a running race without anywhere to run to, or a football match without a ball. Now, I want us to use this idea as a bow and arrow to think about our reading that we heard today. That reading that Will read that said about faith, hope and love. And I'm wondering if we can have three arrows that are faith, hope and love. If they are our arrows, I wonder what their targets might be. Perhaps take a moment to talk to the person you're with, if you're with someone, or if you're on your own, ponder that question and everybody can share their ideas in the chat if you would like. So I wonder what you came up with. Paul speaks of faith in Jesus. So my suggestion is that Jesus is the target of our faith arrow. Paul speaks of love for all the saints. So my suggestion is that people are the target of our love arrow. And Paul speaks and writes about the hope laid up for you in heaven. So my suggestion is that heaven is the target of our hope arrow. But how are these arrows going to get to their targets? There needs to be some action. They need to be given energy. Without energy, without firing that arrow, it's a useless object. Faith, hope and love are not passive things. They're not just nouns. They're verbs, action words. We can say, I believe, I love, I hope. They're not merely things we have. They are things we do. So what does faith in action look like? What does love in action look like? What does hope in action look like? Again, if you're with someone in your house, perhaps take a moment or two to think about those questions. Or if you're on your own, ponder your thoughts on it. And if you want to, anyone can write their thoughts in the chat. Paul wrote to the church in Thessalonica that we constantly bear in mind your work of faith, your labour of love and your perseverance of hope. Faith is a crucial piece of our relationship with God. Faith in action involves spending time with him, reading our Bibles, reflecting, listening and praying. The church plays a part in helping and growing faith and seeing it in action. Love in action is shown in more practical and tangible ways. Jesus said, love one another as I have loved you. Love your neighbours and love your enemies. This pandemic has given us many more ways in which we have seen love in action for those we know and care for and for those we don't. Checking in on a friend or neighbour, a telephone call or a message to a loved one, a gift, a kind word, an act of service. When we're allowed, a hug. Perhaps giving to one can, supporting charities, working with those in need. So many different ways of showing love to one another. Hope in action is trying to focus on the bigger picture. Hope is the belief that although things can be grim, even downright bad, that somewhere in the midst of all that mess, there is goodness and there is God. There is light in the darkness and the expectation that there are better days ahead. Hope in action is holding on to the promise of eternal life, life that will last forever when this life ends. Again, during this pandemic, it's sometimes felt that we've been losing hope. Hope that things will change. Hope that we'll get our lives back. Hope that the future is brighter than the present. In the words of Captain Tom, hope that tomorrow is a good day. So our arrows need energy, they need action, and they need a target, but they also need something else. An arrow needs to successfully hit the target and stay, not bounce off, which I've had a number of times happen to me. So how does this happen? I believe it's a choice and a commitment. Joshua, the Old Testament character, posed the question, choose this day who you serve, saying, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Each day we have a choice about putting faith, hope and love into practice. Some days it will be easier than others. Some days we may celebrate great success in our faith, hope and love. We will be encouraged, we will be strengthened and we will be inspired and enthused to keep on going. Other days we might try and fail. Other days we might try and fail, and that's when commitment to coming back the next day, and when asked that question, what do you choose today, you commit to choosing faith, hope and love again. So as we come to a close, I want to tell you about our Heart Bomb idea. From today and for the next week or so, get involved in showing people that they matter to you, to us and to God. You could decorate your window with a heart display. You could paint a stone with a heart and hide it around the village. You could send a message of love and support to someone you know. There are lots of different ideas. Get creative and spread the love. During lockdown part one, Graham Kendrick, who also wrote Shine Jesus Shine, Servant King and lots of other worship songs, wrote a song called A Little Bit of Love Goes a Long, Long Way. And we're going to listen to that song now.
A little bit of love goes a long, long way. A little love, a little love, a little bit of love and I'm on my way. A little love, a little love, a long way but we'll get there together. A long way but we'll get there soon. Along the way we can lean on each other. A little love goes a long, long way. A little love, a little love, a little bit of love and the sun comes shining. A little love, a little love, a little bit of kindness and someone smiling. A little love, a little love, a long way but we'll get there together. A long way but soon. Along the way we can lean on each other. A little love goes a long, long way. A little love, a little love.
Little drops of rain can trickle down into a puddle. Then the puddles get together, making streams that make a river.
The rivers fill the valleys with the roaring and the rushing. Then the little drops of rain have made a wide, 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 wide ocean. A long way but we'll get there together. A long way but we'll get there soon. Along the way we can lean on each other. A little love goes a long, long way. A long way but we'll get there together. A long way but we'll get there soon. Along the way we can lean on each other. A little love goes a long, long way. A little love, a little love, a little
As we start our time of prayer, we give thanks for sunshine and snow, for food and drink, for homes and gardens, for family and friends, for health and fitness, for hobbies and everything we enjoy. We give you thanks. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Faith. Lord God, we thank you for our church. We pray for Holy Trinity, Seer Green and Jordans, and for our benefice. Please give wisdom to the leadership and PCC as they look ahead and plan for the future. Thank you for the new ways in which we can gather together online and continue to strengthen our faith, pray, praise and worship you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hope. Lord God, we ask that you will give us hope. We pray for all those who are worried about their futures. In these continuing difficult and uncertain times, thank you that our hope can be found in you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Love. Today we pray for those we love, for our family, friends, neighbours and community. Lord God, we pray for those who are lonely, for those who are isolated, for those missing family and friends. We pray for those in our community who are sick, sad, bereaved or in need of help. We bring them to you in a moment of quiet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of love, we thank you that you hear our prayers. We will now join in with the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
So we come to our notices. There's lots in our weekly sheet as always. Please do look through it. I'm very pleased to say that next month's Parish Magazine will be delivered. That is because we've had some help from some wonderful teenagers who are doing their Gold Duke of Edinburgh Award. So our thanks go to them and to others who have arranged to have it distributed alongside our wonderful distributors who have been delivering our magazine for years and years and years. Our thanks, huge thanks, go to them as well. This year, our Lent theme will be focusing on soul shepherding or self-care. We have been through such a difficult time, and indeed it is continuing. So we thought it would be a good time for us to focus on what the Christian resources are to help us to cope with exhaustion, grief and anxiety, and how our identity in Christ, who we are as Christians and who we are loved by as Christians, can help us in these very difficult times to find rest and refreshment. So that's going to be our theme for Lent this year. So no giving up, but a little bit of taking up a lot of resting in God. That will be our theme. So more information about that over the next couple of weeks. And we're now going to sing that wonderful hymn, Love Divine or Love's Excelling. And so we come towards the end of our service. May I invite you to come and join me in the coffee and chat Zoom room after the service. It will be lovely to see you. Let's pray for God's blessing on us. May the God of love bless you with the knowledge of his love so that you can love as he loves us. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and those whom you love and for whom you pray, now and always. Amen.
A little bit of love goes a long, long way. A little love, a little love, a little bit of love, and I'm on my way. A little love, a little love, a long way, but we'll get there together. A long way, but we'll get there soon. Along the way, we can lean on each other. A little love goes a long, long way. A little love, a little love.